time to pull those items out. So. Exactly. And it makes sense, man. I think that counter pick to Cloud was a great, great option. But now, looks like we got the boy. Ooh. You know him, you love him, MKLeo.
Yeah, really innovative player. Plays very many characters. We've recently seen the Bayonetta added to the list.
Yes, yes. Don't say that too loud, man. Some people.
Oh, dang.
Some people get really mad about that. But I like it, man. Best character in the game. Yeah. Best, one of the best players in the game. Might as well, you know.
Oh yeah. And I mean, you know, he's out here trying to win. So I definitely respect the decision, and it's going to be really cool because I want to see how he innovates the characters. The character has so much options and is so, like, underdeveloped. So it's going to be really interesting. But we also have legit Diddy Kong main from NorCal. Definite. I'm not sure what he is this season, but definite, like, consistent top five in NorCal.
Nice. All right. Very interesting. You know, actually, the NorCal scene, I feel like, is one of the scenes I don't really know as much about. Obviously, I've been in SoCal so often with the, you know, the 2GG events and the Esports Arena down there. But now they have an Esports Arena up here, Esports Oakland. I think I'm going to learn a lot more about these players.
Oh, yeah. I'm so happy just for the NorCal scene in general. This is a really good opportunity for them. And Legit was even able to take out Nairo at Genesis. So let's see if he can add another name to that list.
Oh, yeah. He's trying to add to his hit list here. Has MKLeo at 99 off stage right now. Nana in hand though, so he's still in good position. Ooh, down tilt. Oh, the worst possible thing that could happen, man.
And a lot of people are starting to do a really good job. That one was a little harder to DI in because he DI'd out on the down tilt. But Leo DI'd in on the down tilt and on that up smash, so he was able to fall up. But the sword dance, not able to clean it up yet.
Yeah, zero rage, of course, so he's not going to be able to get the stock there.
Okay,
that's scary though. You know, Martha's always had this dancing blade. And I feel like MKLeo was really the person who realized, like, yo, this could KO very often, but you know, in that situation, he's not going to need it. He's going to get the tipper with the forward smash.
At 150, why not?
Yeah.
I wouldn't be surprised if that took two stocks.
Yeah,
like, honestly, you just win the game.
Didn't even need the tipper for that.
Yeah, that dancing blade, it's such a quick move, and it's just been one of Marth's better
startup
moves since, from Brawl, of course. So. And, like, the way Leo delays the last hit so he gets a tipper form, because there, to my knowledge, there was no tipper in Brawl.
Yeah, as far as I know,
yeah. So in this game, they added tipper properties to it. So Leo definitely abuses that.
So let's see. He's definitely abusing Legit here. Has quite the lead on him. It's true, man. Legit trying to figure out how to bring this one back. But Leo will not let him play around with that banana.
It's so hard because, you know, Leo has fought Zero many, many times, of course, and yep, there's that stall.
Classic, dude. I swear I didn't see, you know, no disrespect to the other Marth players, but I really didn't see any of the other Marth players really taking advantage of Dancing Blade until I saw MKLeo play him.
Yeah. And especially,
I'm
going to
get blown up for
edge.
That later, man. Some of the Marth players can be like, DC,
oh,
what,
no, the witch hunt begins?
About? Yeah.
The witch hunt?
But obviously, MKLeo finding great success with the character.
Oh, yeah. And it's really cool that he's, like, able to switch off and all that stuff. And it can just be really hard because Leo, you know, before Zero retired, he did a pretty good job against Zero's Diddy Kong. So just being legit, it can be very, very difficult to play someone that has that experience and, you know, just that general, like, game plan against Diddy Kong.
And Dancing Blade truly having it all. Like I said before, 6-frame startup, it has that KO attack with the forward ender, but has the damage, you know, ton of damage from the downward ender. I think it's actually like a maximum of like 22 or 24% damage.
Yeah, it's insane.
Which is really, really nuts when you think about a 6-frame startup attack.
You know, a move's good when it's like, oh, like, I want this early game, mid game, late game. Like,
yeah,
it has
right?
uses like all the time. Like, it's good damage and I killed it. Awesome. And like you said, frame 6, and it's that Marth sword. It is disjointed. You can do a really good job and just space out with it. But legit, finally getting in, opening up, getting these dash grabs going.
Yeah. I feel like a lot of the first game and some of this game already has been trying to get that banana out, establish himself in the neutral.
Oh, no. Gets the air dodge, no tipper, though.
All right, banana finally in hand and has his feet on the stage. So let's see what he can do with this. Finds an opening, back throw off stage. Yeah, this is it. This is the Diddy Kong washing machine, man.
Oh no, but Leo escapes the washer. And that's where Diddy Kong really has to capitalize. Up throw, gonna be it.
Oh, hit with a Brett Favre, dude.
Oh, yeah.
Crazy.
Because once Diddy just gets people on the ledge, he can just ledge trap people forever. But
oh, yeah.
Leo himself is really just good at ledge trapping. I feel like his understanding of ledge trapping is really good. So you're just going to see him.
Oh, the aggression. Dude, you know what? You know what the worst thing is? Legit probably thought, I'm safe down here. You know, there's no way MKLeo is going to dash down. Dude, MKLeo did not let him breathe. Chased him off stage. You saw him try to get that early KO with the up B. Missed it, but ended up ledge dropping for it.
He's not done.
He's like, I'm not done yet. No,
I'm not done.
I want this KO. All right? 2-0 MKLeo. Let's see what Legit has in store for game number 3.
Yeah, Leo's pressure game. It's just so hard to escape, even when he has you on the ledge. And he didn't really go off the whole set, really. Yep. And like the one time he knew it would work, he goes for it. So really smart stuff from Leo.
Yeah, like you had mentioned earlier, this man has played Zero in his prime, and you know, done very well against Zero in his prime. So it's gonna be really hard to be a Diddy Kong player, and try to find the crack in MKLeo's armor. I don't think he's gonna give it up that easily, man.
Oh yeah, and especially with Marth too. It's not a lot of people like Marth. Leo does great things with Marth, but it's not a very meta character.
Oh, yeah.
You don't see it a lot in tournament. So definitely, Legit might not have as much experience against this character for sure.
He tried to hit him with the classic Diddy Kong there, man. Banana on the edge into down air. I haven't actually seen that in a while, man. I think people have learned.
Ooh! That sword was pretty close.
I love it, though. MKLeo does that. He knows, like, even if I miss this, yeah, you're forced to air dodge here. I'm safe, dude.
Yeah. And, like, how far they have to drift away as well. So, Leo just able to really make those risks and, like, very safe risks.
Got to watch those monkey flips returning the stage, man. That is something that gets Zero... you know, we've seen it happen in the past a lot. Gets Zero killed a lot.
Oh, yeah. It's such a great option, but no matter what, the thing that's really awesome about Smash, even, like, broken options have really good counterplay.
Oh, yeah. And MKLeo definitely knows the counterplay to that.
Oh, yeah.
See, the classic Legit shielding right behind that banana makes him very, very hard to approach. But honestly, MKLeo with the lead here does not need to approach. So,
oh, wow. What a beautiful stall on that dancing blade. And Leo, he's able to stay close enough to Legit, like, he's still not really aggressing in, but he's staying close enough. Like, if you pull a banana, it's mine.
Oh, yeah. This is very, very hard for Legit. You can tell he's probably very used to establishing his neutral with the banana, as most Diddy Kong players are. But, you know, once MKLeo's not letting him, not allowing him to pull those bananas out, and he's really struggling finding these kills, finding his way in and winning neutral.
Yeah, and then just Leo just, ooh, okay, the Force Master should do it. And just people of MKLeo's caliber, you know, all those people, top 5, top 10, their pressure game is just immense. It can be so hard to deal with. It can even feel suffocating at times. Ooh, and that's going to be the banana slip into the up smash.
You ever see the hitbox for that attack, dude? Hitbox starts
at his
pinky toes, dude. It's crazy.
Yeah, yeah. I've seen people get stage spiked, like, underneath the stage.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that before.
Like, on Battlefield especially, like, someone's, like, up-beating, someone goes for an up smash.
That's a well-designed hitbox, dude. That's worth it.